How's it going, everybody? Jordan here, and in today's video, I'm gonna go over my epic fire sword build for Assassin's Creed Odyssey. This build, when used with the overpowered quick attack combo, can kill mercenaries in one hit and is tons of fun to play and deals a lot of damage. A lot of you have been asking me for an epic fire sword build, and this is it. Let's get right into it. The key part to this epic fire sword build is going to be the combo of using the quick overpowered attack that comes with swords and daggers. Now, if you weren't familiar, the overpowered attacks for swords and daggers are single target attacks. And what they do is they provide a long animation if you've used them before, and it takes a long time, and it deals some damage, but it doesn't deal quite as much damage as other abilities do. But there's a unique mechanic in the game that if an enemy is on the ground or at a different elevation than you, and you use one of these overpowered attacks from the dagger or the sword, it does all the damage of that animation, plus applies additional crit and elemental damage, and makes you hit extremely hard. With this build, I was getting 70 million plus damage with this quick attack. Using this combo of knocking someone down with either Ring of Chaos, Sparta Kick, or any other abilities that knock people down, and then hitting them with the overpowered attack while they're on the ground would result in instant kills on mercenaries and obliterates anyone you come up against. Now, it is important to say that Tetracycloid, our moderator in our Discord community, was one of the ones that kind of showcased this. And if you've seen any of those high damage dealing videos, they're using this trick to do that. So this can be used with swords or daggers. I chose to use the sword because a lot of you have been asking for a fire sword to build, and this is it. Now, while we're talking about this, before we get into the gear, let's quickly discuss the other benefits of the sword. The sword is one of the higher attack speed weapons in the game with lower armor penetration. It does have a shield breaking combo, which is extremely useful if you're coming up against shield enemies and you're not using the shield break ability, but having that additional attack speed and that overpowered combo mixed with a little bit of a longer reach because it's longer than daggers makes for a really good weapon type. And it's been incredibly fun to play with this build and deals a lot of damage in all different parts of the game. Lastly, this build is going to rely on some tankiness and a lot of crit damage while at full health, just so you're aware. All right, let's get right into the gear details. For my primary epic sword weapon, I'm going to be using warrior damage, crit damage, damage with swords, and then engrave 40% fire damage on top of that. For my secondary weapon, we're using the reward from killing the Minotaur, the Minotaur's Labyrinth, which gives you warrior damage, crit damage, and then a -1 adrenaline cost for overpowered abilities, and then a 40% fire damage engraving on top of that. The reason I use this weapon is because I'm using that overpowered attack, trick attack. I want to have reduced adrenaline cost for that, so I'm willing to sacrifice a little bit of damage so that I can keep using that ability as often as possible. For the bow here, we're going to use warrior damage, crit chance, fire damage, and then we're going to engrave the 30% armor penetration. For the head, we're going to have warrior damage, damage with swords, fire damage, and then crit chance while at full health. On the gauntlets, these will be our crit warrior gauntlets. We have warrior damage, crit chance, and crit damage while at full health. What we have here is warrior damage, total armor, health, and then an engraving of 50% crit damage. On the waist, we're going to have warrior damage, and crit chance, and then I went ahead and engraved it with 30% melee resistance. On our boots, we're going to have warrior damage, crit chance while at full health, crit damage while at full health, and then engraving the 40% fire damage. All right, let's look at the masteries for this build. Again, like I always mention, if you don't have as much ability points as I do, just focus on putting your points into the main ones that I feature, and if you have extra, you can put them where that is. So the primary ones you want to put points into is damage with swords, crit chance while at full health, crit damage while at full health, damage while at full health, and then on the warrior side, you're going to want to put points into health, armor, melee resistance, fire damage, and damage dealt restored as health, because you will be taking some hits and you want to get that health back to stay at full health. Now, if you have the extra points, I would recommend putting them into adrenaline per crit so that you can keep getting more adrenaline segments back so that you can use that overpowered attack. And also, if you have the extra points, putting them into the crit damage on the hunter tree for additional crit damage. And then lastly, putting some points into damage per enemy engaged, so as you're getting swarmed, you're dealing a bit more damage. All right, let's look at the stats for this build. It's really incredible. Again, as always, in the description of this video will be a link to the ac-builds.com build link where you can get all the details on your mobile phone, so you don't have to watch this video again unless you really want to. But let's look at the primary increasing. So obviously, while we're at full health, we have an above 90% crit chance. This is definitely the key for dealing a lot of damage in a lot of builds. But even with that, we were still able to get a 660% crit damage and an 84% damage with swords, and matching that with a 256% fire damage. Now, this is very good for a warrior damage dealing build, but what I like about this is we were still able to hit all those points and add a lot of tankiness to it. We have a 32% health bonus, a nearly 200% armor bonus, and a whopping 48% melee resistance. And then with masteries, you can get an 18.1% range resistance boost as well, making this build not incredibly tanky, but tanky enough to be able to engage several units at the same time and take them all on. All right, let's go over the primary abilities that I use with this build. Because I'm not engraving weapon damage becomes fire damage, we're relying on flaming attacks to be our primary ability to turn fire on to deal that additional 250% damage. On our second ability, we're using Ring of Chaos, and the reason is for two things: crowd control, and then mainly to knock high profile enemies like mercenaries down so that we can use the overpowered attacks on them to get that quick instant kill. My third ability is slow time. I've really been enjoying slow time lately because it lets you make a lot more decisions quicker because time is slowed. So it's a very useful ability in my opinion. And then lastly, we're putting points into second wind as always because we want that health to stay at full health. It's important to remember to put points into overpowered attacks. Again, this build relies heavily on it and uses that overpowered attack engraving, so it only costs 2 adrenaline segments to use this ability. And then the rest of the points I put into passive masteries like Shadow Assassin, Weapons Master, Gear Master, etc. All right, let's look at the transmog for this build. So for the sword, what I went ahead and used was the Epsilon Blade, which I think comes from the Helix story, but there's a lot of really cool, like ceremonial sword and things like that, really cool silver swords that go along with it. I just like the way the Epsilon Blade look. On the helmet, we're using the decorated Thracian helm, the adorned silver version. On the gauntlets, we're using heavy Athenian bracers with, again, the adorned silver variation. On the chest, we're using the heavy Athenian breastplate. On the waist, we're using the silver version of the Agamemnon's waistband. And then lastly, for the boots, we're using the sunken greaves here, the adorned silver version as well, giving it this really well polished silver look that I really like, and I feel like it matches the flaming sword really well. All right, so that's my flaming sword build. A lot of you've been asking to do fire swords. The main reason I didn't use the Prometheus's Sika with this build, which is a legendary fire sword, is because I'm not a big fan of the legendary engraving of that sword. It only gives you a 15% fire damage boost, when something like an epic sword or other legendary swords, you can engrave 40% fire damage on top of them. So I knew a couple of you would ask me, why didn't you use the Prometheus of Sika? That's why. This build is incredibly fun to play, especially with that combo, the overpowered attack combo, and I really enjoyed it. And I honestly, this is kind of got attached to this one, and I'll likely be playing it in the future on live streams as well. Lastly, what do you guys think of the Fire Sword? Are you guys attached to any particular weapon type? I know I'm more of a staff guy, but using the overpowered attack with the sword really shows that any type of weapon type in this game can be fun depending on how you use it. So I'd really love to hear from you what experiences or tricks or things you've been doing with other weapon types that make them incredibly fun to play. I'd love to hear from you in the comments. As always, if you enjoyed the video, a like would be super appreciated. It really helps the channel out. And please click the subscribe button and then the bell in order to get more Assassin's Creed Odyssey content. As always, I appreciate all of you guys, and I'll see you guys next time.
So proud of those born to be Spartans.